Hey guys, Brad from Team Crimson here, and welcome to Crimson Debate. Today we're going to be talking about, is it the death knell of Vanguard? Has the bell rung for Vanguard? I'm going to be presenting you with a couple of reasons for why we believe that could be true, and a couple of reasons why we believe that that could be not so true. And we're going to be kind of debating it, talking about it a little bit. First, let's introduce our other panelists here. We have Zach. Just Zach. The artist previously known as Zach the Great. We have Declan.
Nice.
I hope you hear that it's quiet enough that you hear the paper turning. All right, so that's what we're going to be talking about. We're going to talk about a couple of facts here, but it's mostly going to be just kind of presenting some of our viewpoints. But we always try to leave it in the audience's hands. What do you think? Let us know your thoughts about our discussions as well. Let us know in the comments section. Let us know if you agree, you disagree, whatever. That's what we like to hear. That's what this video is here for. All right, so the death knell of Vanguard. Is this the death of the card game? So a couple of points that I wanted to bring up here. So I think it's very widely regarded for the most part by a majority of the player base that this year in particular, mostly attributed to the virus, the ongoing pandemic, even as far as the actual cards were released and stuff this year, it's been a shitty year. I don't think anyone has liked or enjoyed this year in particular. I wanted to kind of bring across the point too that currently we are in a tier zero meta. Unless if Overdress comes out and actually addresses the inherent problems with standard, unless Overdress comes out and it's an actual full-blown reboot or something like that, something to that extent, and Bushi doesn't do anything about the tier zero format we're in, which looks like they aren't, we are going to be living with this tier zero format from December all the way through till at least late April, possibly into May. That's a long time to be living with an unhealthy format and them not really addressing it. But I also wanted to go ahead and say 2020, judging by my math, we have had four tier zero metas throughout this year. And if you compare that to 2019, which had one, kind of two, and 2018, which had one, that's significant. That's significant. That shows inherent problems and how Bushiroad is running its game with power creep in particular, but especially with just how they aren't policing their own game. They're not doing a good job creating cards. They're not doing a good job of balancing cards. They're literally, let's throw all of our eggs into this one basket, into this one clan, and everything else gets shit. I'm just going to go over some of the tier zero formats that we've had this year, and I'll go over a couple from before as well. So the one we're living in right now, which is Gurgwit. If you're not playing Gurgwit, you'll lose. That's what we're living in right now. Before that was mostly attributed to the Japanese market. We didn't really have it, but that was Tier Zero Luard. But within the main, it became less Tier Zero and ridiculously high Tier One. But we still are going to count that because that still happened. That's still Bushi Road screwing up. And on top of it, Luard was absolutely ridiculous. Then we also had Dragon's Vanity. We had Vanquisher. Vanquisher and Revan were at the top, but if you weren't playing Vanquisher, you weren't winning for quite some time there. And then also in January, we had Crystal Melody, which was Bermuda. And that was Tier Zero until they decided to finally hit it. The things I wanted to address there, Crystal Melody, they did hit. They got rid of that problem when they needed to. Dragon's Vanity got Vanquisher got power crept out, but it took a while. It took a long while, and I think it took a while before they actually addressed the problem, which was Cho-Oh. They hit Cho-Oh, even though I don't think it was really doing that much at the time anyways, but they did address that problem late. But Vanquisher did get power crept out. With Phantom Dragon Aeon, of course, we all know the big issue there. They got rid of Nemain. I think it's debatable whether or not that was the right choice. I think we see, for the most part, that probably wasn't the right choice, especially card shops in Japan and players just flip their absolute collective shits. And then on top of it, now we have the Divine Lightning Radiance with Gurgwit. So then in 2019, the Tier Zero format for that year was in May, and it was Primary Melody, also a Bermuda set, which went on for quite some time before it finally got power crept out. It took a while. And then we had a slight, I'm going to count this, but I'm only going to say slight. And it's Phantasmal Steed with that set in late September. And that was Murakumo with Hyuga. Hyuga was topping ridiculous, ridiculously topping for quite a while, but it did also slowly get power crept out. And I think Shirayaki got hit. I think that affected it, or I can't remember. But and then in 2018, we basically only had Imperial Daughter of the Meta. But yeah, so I wanted to go over some of that and kind of refresh your guys' memories of that. I think there's a lot of burnout on Vanguard players' parts. I know that's being experienced on our team as well. What are your guys' thoughts? What do you think? Is this a possible death of Vanguard? And what do you think is contributing to it? Go to Zach first.
It's hard to say, but I know a lot of people, at least in our community, talking about how bad the game has gotten, and then Digimon is coming out here soon, and they all want to get into that. A lot of players are saying that Digimon is going to be the next big thing and all that good stuff.